much you will be gone.
Hi guys, how are you doing? So we're here with my friends and we're gonna do a taste test of Sarsaparilla versus root beer. They don't know what's in the glasses, so we're gonna try to figure out what it is. And we're gonna do a drum roll. Yay!
Timekeeper, right?
Yeah.
And tremor extraordinaire.
That's what I've been told. Or myself.
Yeah.
The point of this video is to figure out what is Sarsaparilla and what is root beer and how are they different, how are they the same. This is the first one that we're gonna try and they're gonna describe what it's like and we don't know what it is.
Alright, ready?
Do you know the vintage?
I say root beer.
I say sarsaparilla.
Can I change my answer?
No, dude. No.
Oh man. So what I haven't told you is that I don't like root beer. And so I can't tell.
Can you guys describe what you've tasted?
It tastes to me like licorice.
A little licorice-y, a little kind of herbal.
Herbal.
Yeah.
Like very herbal.
Very, yeah. Like
but it still has the creaminess that you get with root beer.
Mm. Right. It reminded me of...
Or it could be root beer, but I don't know. But that little herbalness kind of...
Like that...
Sharp.
What's that awful liquor that tastes like roots?
Oh,
Frenet Blanc.
Or they also have Jaeger that tastes like black licorice.
Yeah, yeah.
This isn't as strong as a Jaeger.
It's sweet.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Very sweet.
Syrupy sweet.
We're gonna try this one. We don't know what it is. We'll see.
Oh, well then. What is this?
It's very bitter.
Yeah. It's not as sweet as the first one I drank.
Whoa.
It tastes more like medicine.
I prefer this one.
You like this one?
Yeah. Maybe because it's a little less sweet and it's a little less rooty, a little bit less herbal. More.
I don't know.
I'm dying to know which one is which.
Oh,
Basilio was still.
I have to do the side by side.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You have something I can clean my palate with?
Where's the whiskey?
Where's the whiskey? Shot of crab.
It's
fresher
to me.
Yeah.
The second one is like more bright.
So the first one seems a little like sharper on the tongue.
Yeah. This one is really muted, so it's not
as
strong.
Yeah, this one's more bland and subtle.
Yeah, this one is definitely
actually, this one doesn't taste like anything.
It's weird. I think because this one has so much more bite to it.
It's like more potent.
So which is which? Are you going to do the reveal?
So the first one that we tasted is this one. Can you guys see it? And the second one that we had is this one. So, okay, the first one that we have is root beer.
Really?
And then the second one is sarsaparilla.
That's the foamy one. Okay.
Really?
Sarsaparilla. But these are the same manufacturer.
Yeah, so that's basically the control. We got root beer and sarsaparilla from the same maker, that's Rayleigh's, the grocery store.
Canada.
Yeah, so
local, right? Really?
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
So it sounds like
Sacramento.
Like majority of us like root beer better. Is that right?
Yeah.
That would say you're right.
Woo! Sacramento.
So pass, we're filling these up. We're gonna take it.
Yeah,
out.
We're gonna.
So you wanna do the
duties? So this one has to hold, so I have to hold it like this. This one has a hole.
Oh.
What?
Like a dribble glass?
Yeah, so I have to hold it like this.
Is it supposed to be like that?
It's supposed to be like this.
Oh,
see, you only fill it up to here. So I get this one.
Before.
I think it's like a practical joke.
I know, this is me.
Like one of those.
I've
like,
never done before.
Like, really?
I would be drinking that.
Do you want to fill it up?
Yeah. That's why I got it.
Cover it.
Let me see.
Okay, go.
Cover it tight.
Can you see it? Can you see it?
Really?
Yeah, here.
Yeah.
Do you want the full shot or do you want just a little?
No, no, I just want a little because I don't agree.
Oh, well, now we're having a good old time. Okay, here, where's I'm trying to find the little. Oh, there.
That's so funny. There's the hole.
Like, wait, look, it's just covering it. Look, it's not as deep as those.
Yeah.
What is this madness?
What?
This is for like people to cheat with. They like to like cheat while they're like drinking.
This is silly. I need some of these.
It's not like the same level.
Is this so you can slip some roofie at a bar?
I basically got these shot glasses from Samshi Gil in Seoul, Korea. My last trip.
These are from South Korea, right?
South Korea. It's so, so last week.
I can't abide by those North Koreans.
So last week we found out that the founder of Tower Records passed away. Russ Solomon passed away, and he was 92 years old, and he was drinking whiskey while watching the Oscars. So this is our toast to Russ Solomon. We're all former Tower employees. And we'd like to thank Russ Solomon for Tower Records.
Thank you, Russ.
Thanks, Russ.
Yeah, thank you, Russ.
Man. Thank you.
Thank you.
Quite a ride.
Okay.
Cheers.
Cheers, everybody.
Cheers. 1, 2, 3.
Cheers, Russ.
Cheers,
no music, no life.
Cheers, Tower. Yeah. what was it? Play life loud. That was the last
time. The difference is selection.
Just these glasses.
She's gonna record us like
glasses.
See, that's like. See, that was just a little, but kind of.
It feels
good. It needs the nostrils.
Makes you want to have more.
Yeah, exactly. What did you. This is what you're being.
A little bit.
I think you should take it out of one of these glasses, the bigger ones.
Which one? See, I was still holding it. There's like.
That's so funny.
So I was like, I got ripped off. I need a shot.
The crown is good.
Just a little bit.
Collectible pouch.
Yeah, there you go.
Well, you know, I was like, I'm like, this is kind of classy, you know? This is like a crown. A crown's pretty just like, it's not Jack. You know?
Yeah, it's a Canadian version of the, it's like a good, like, nice.
But I like it. I like it. I mean,
is that the Canadian version?
Well, it's Canadian whiskey.
Yeah.
It's Canadian style whiskey.
Yeah.
But
Toronto, Ontario, Canada.
But it's like, you know, that Scotch type whiskey, and then they have the Canadian.
You know.
Did you know that there's a proper way to drink whiskey?
Oh, tell me.
Okay, so basically you hold up the glass to your nose first and you smell it. And you go from side to side. And then you take the whiskey and gargle it in your mouth for a couple of seconds.
No.
Gargle?
And then swallow it.
Really?
So it's smoother, it goes down smoother in your throat.
Well, I'll be the judge.
Right?
Let's test out this theory.
Yeah, so.
My point is just to power it down. Get it down.
Get it down as fast as you can.
Down into the gullet.
Alright.
And I let the swishing happen post gullet.
Or.
Oh, this has the hole. Thanks for that. Alright. Watch this. I'm gonna cover the hole, but I'm gonna fill it.
Now. Oh my God.
Drink it out of the hole.
Smell it, and do the side to side thing.
Cheers. Thanks for it. Okay.
Alright, let's see.
I forgot to swish.
And we forgot to, yeah, do the side to side thing.
Do we need to say
all right,
A after everything?
I have to say it.
Do I need to say A?
Right, oh my gosh. I need some.
That's pretty good, eh?
Pretty damn good, eh? It's like Great White North back in the strange brew.
Right on, Hoser.
I can break up my Michigan accent if you want. Yeah. This was pretty good pop, actually.
Pop! The pop is a dead giveaway. Mm-hmm.
I trained myself out of this. I mean, legit a long time.
Or worsh. I've heard worsh. Like,
oh, yeah.
Wash.
I don't say that, but I know a lot of people say worsh. Washington.
Yeah, yeah.
And they always say that they're going to major things.
Yeah, major. California, but we have our own accents.
Oh, yeah.
You can't go to Wyoming and say hella.
No. No,
what are you talking about?
Or hecka.
Or hecka, a very.
No, hella is very. That's even.
Very big area, right?
Exactly.
Because you go to Southern California and they're like. No.
It trickled down definitely to the Bay, but it was very first
point
in Sacramento. I can attest to that.
Oh, yeah.
90s.
Sacramento.
Oh, man.
It was one of the first words I picked up regionally when I lived out here. It was hella. There was even a great band.
Zach Hill? Zach Hill and drums?
Zach Hill, Bee Scrubber, looks like Adam from Muppet Show.
What's the other band? What's that band he's in now?
Are you a native Sacramento?
Death Grips.
Yes.
Oh,
yes.
You are?
I was born and raised in West Sacramento.
Oh, wow.
So, not really Sacramento. But once I was 8th grade and I found a skateboard and then I found out that there's that little golden bridge that you could cross and there was like a little city there, I was like, oh, I want to go here, I want to live here. So it was a whole other world.
And Midtown's very much different now, right?
Oh my god.
No,
I'm old. I live with the cuffs. I got a house in the burbs.
We have a favorite Southside bar that we go to. That's about it.
I'm getting a buzz.
That's the point.
Yeah, it's
and then when that happens,
I didn't see
you
taking a shot. So,
Brian, you want to take a shot?
I'm not at this moment.
We'll take one for you.
Yeah, it's only four.
I'm
not
going to try to take it. I'll take one for the road.
So we'll see you guys later.
Bye.
I'm back. So I forgot to introduce my friends. I'm Mick. It's Mick DB. It's my channel.
Hi, I'm Mark.
Basilio.
Lisa. Oh, Lisa.
And we're dating.
We're good. Thanks you guys for joining us. We'll be back soon. Bye.
Bye.
If you like this video, make sure to hit that like button below. Share it with your friends and be sure to subscribe because I post new videos every week. Thank you so much for watching!